I'm Alana, and you're watching Button Bash. Deep Silver have partnered with Occupant Entertainment to go ahead with a Dead Island movie that was originally announced back in 2011. Apparently, Occupant are set up to package, produce, and finance the movie, which originally fell through alongside Lionsgate. Deep Silver had to wait until the rights reverted and took the project to Occupant, who were one of the original bidders. Deep Silver said, "The Dead Island universe offers a rich and unique setting that can expand beyond the pure gaming experience. We are very much looking forward to seeing Dead Island open up to new audiences and showing off the fun everybody at Deep Silver has had with the brand." On a more game-related note, Dead Island 2 is currently in development for the Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC, but Deep Silver are also working on a MOBA called Dead Island Epidemic and a stealth-based game called Escape Dead Island for the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and PC. That's a whole lot of Dead Island. MapleStory 2 is an upcoming RPG and the lineal sequel to the 2D MMORPG, MapleStory. Aside from MapleStory 2 having Minecraft-esque 3D graphics, the games are apparently not related to one another. With that in mind, here's a new trailer, showing off the online customization and user-created content.
그 넓은 땅일수록 아주 비싸서 이런 땅을 가지려면 많은 돈이 필요합니다. 땅을 구입했다면 마음대로 꾸밀 차례입니다. 건설 모드로 전환하여 원하는 곳에 오브젝트를 배치합니다. 땅에 건물을 배치한 후 건물 내부를 꾸밀 수 있습니다. 내 땅에는 꾸미기 오브젝트뿐만 아니라 기능성 아이템을 놓을 수 있습니다. 상자를 배치하여 아이템을 보관할 수 있고 특별한 효과를 가진 기념품을 배치할 수도 있으며
USAopoly and Hasbro have announced a Legend of Zelda version of the Monopoly board game, set to release in September. All of the properties, player tokens, and the currency, rupees of course, are going to be super familiar to Zelda fans, and the quality looks outstanding. The Legend of Zelda Monopoly Edition is going to be arriving on September 15th for $39.99 with some exclusive pre-order bonuses at GameStop. The developers of the next Gears of War, Black Tusk, formerly known as Microsoft Vancouver, are working hard to ensure the upcoming Xbox One title stays true to the series. Black Tusk producer and producer on Gears of War 1 and 2, Rob Ferguson, said, "With Black Tusk, we have to show that we have legitimate claim to this IP and be able to show we know how to do it right before we do it differently." He also mentioned other games trying to copy the Gears of War cover system but failing, and I actually have to agree with Ferguson there. The Gears of War series is one of the first to have that third-person shooter-style cover system, and there are a lot of games that have definitely tried to replicate it, but it's never quite as fluid. Regarding the story progression, he also said, "There's lots of stuff. Backstory from E-Day, Pendulum Wars, all the way to Gears 3. There's a lot of room in there. But I don't know if that's the place to go. I think there's lots of other places we could go as well." Now, I've actually read the Gears of War books and really, really enjoyed them, and there's so much further detail for the universe in those that the Xbox One Gears of War game has a lot of potential. Microsoft actually purchased the Gears of War franchise from Epic Games earlier this year, which could also influence the game in various unknown ways. 2K Games have announced that the original Bioshock will be coming to iOS platforms sometime soon. 2K promises that they will be bringing a complete experience of the original with optimized touch controls and full iPhone game controller support. The game will be available via the App Store for the iPad, iPhone, and iPod Touch, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how it plays out. It's been a long time since I played the original Bioshock, but I feel like it'd be just really odd to play on a touch device, though I think I remember the first one being a lot more about getting around and hacking things as opposed to the really fast-paced action in Infinite. But maybe I'm just underestimating mobile devices and tablets' gaming abilities. We'll have to wait and see. A leaked trailer and a premature listing on a Swiss games website for a game called Assassin's Creed Rogue seems to have forced Ubisoft to announce the game early. The game is set to launch on November 11 for old-gen consoles, being the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. It's set in the 18th century during the Seven Years' War, with players able to explore a handful of locations in North America. We will be playing as a Templar called Shay, and it will be apparently be completing the saga that started with Assassin's Creed 3 and Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag.
History may brand me traitor, rebel, or renegade. But in the end, it doesn't matter how history remembers me. What matters is that I followed my own creed.
Assassin's Creed Rogue.
I'm Alana, and thanks for watching Button Bash.